Yesterday, we already started a new topic that is nothing but system conversion. Okay, and which is one of the very important topic because there are a lot of customers who are already running a system and they are planning to upgrade their current system to SAP S/4HANA. So for all those customers who want to make the use of their existing SAP ECC system, they don't want to lose any data, they don't want to lose any custom codes, and they don't want to start from scratch. So for them, they will be definitely going for the system conversion project. Okay, and whatever we will be talking about in this conversion phase, it will take another two sessions, I think at least another two sessions to complete the conversion topic. So I will be telling you with respect to all the different versions. Okay, so for example, the system conversion in 1503 or 1511, which was the first version of SAP Simple Finance or S/4HANA Finance, may not be exactly same as what we are using today. So there are a lot of new tools which SAP keeps on adding in each and every version. Okay, so whenever I'll be talking about a particular topic, mainly I'll be talking about 1809 because obviously, whatever is the latest version available in the market, if a customer is implementing SAP S/4HANA, they will definitely go for the latest version which is currently available in the market. Okay, but during the discussion, I will also tell you how this 1809 is new and what was happening in the previous versions wherever applicable. Okay, so I'm not saying everything has been changed. There are some points which are different when they are compared with 1511, 1610, 1709, and 1809. So we'll be discussing all of that, but more specifically, we'll be discussing about the latest one, that is 1809. Okay, so again, one time, if there is any confusion in the mind, what is the difference between the new implementation and system conversion? In system conversion, we are upgrading our current system. In new implementation, we are scrapping our current system and starting a completely new system from scratch. Okay, so that is a whole difference between new implementation and system conversion projects. Okay, now again, this same slide which we seen yesterday also in SAP Activate methodology also. So just remember the difference between two. In new implementation, you have this older systems which will be scrapped. Okay, and you will be manually transferring the data from this system to this system at the time of cutover. Okay, so currently, you are using this SAP system, for example, or non-SAP system. So let's say you are currently using SAP or non-SAP, and then you are building a completely new system from scratch. So at the time of cutover, you have to move the data of GLs, customers, vendors, open items, everything to this new system manually using the BDCs or LSMWs, whatever you want. But when we are talking about system conversion, these two are not different systems. This is your current system, and the same system would be upgraded. Okay, there is only time difference. Before conversion, you are using this system, and after conversion, this system will become S/4HANA system. So you don't need to move any data because data is already available here. Whatever is your customer, vendor, whatever things are available, these are available here itself. You are just upgrading this current system. Okay, so this is just a kind of upgrade that you will be doing. Okay, so this is a basic difference between system conversion and new implementation. Now let's go into detail of system conversion. So what are the different activities that we do in the system conversion project? So in the system conversion, again, it is divided into phases. So I'm not saying that these phases are different than SAP Activate methodology. Okay, even your conversion project will also follow the SAP activate methodology, but within the activate methodology, these are the steps which will be performed. So if I tell you, this preparation activity will be done in the preparation phase of SAP activate methodology. Okay, and all other activities, installation, data configuration, data migration, and post migration, these are the activities relevant to realize phase, realization phase. Okay, because all these things, configuration, data migration, you will be doing after the explore and before the deploy phase. So all these activities, installation, data configuration, data migration, post migration, this is something which we will be doing during the realization phase. Okay, I'll talk about them in detail very shortly, but just remember that I'm not saying the conversion system conversion project will not follow SAP activate methodology. Definitely it will follow activate methodology, but within SAP activate methodology, there will be the preparation phase. Okay, so preparation activities will be done in the preparation phase, and all the remaining activities like installation, data configuration, data migration, and post migration, these will be done during the realization phase. Okay, so now let's try to understand. We will be talking about all these things in detail. What is required in the preparation, what is required in the installation, what is required in data config, data migration, and post migration. But before that, this is something which we discussed yesterday. Okay, the first thing, if I'm using this system here, is this system ready to be migrated to S/4HANA or not? Okay, so whether I can upgrade this system directly to S/4HANA in one step, or I need to upgrade the system to S/4HANA in two steps, that depends upon the version that we are using. Okay, so for a one step conversion, your system needs to have a minimum release level. And what is that minimum release level? It is SAP ERP 6.0 and EHP starting from 0 to 8. Okay, don't worry about the remaining points. Why? Because all the remaining points are above this. Okay, so if you are already on SAP ERP 6.0, EHP 0 to 8, if you are upper than this, then SAP Business Suite powered by HANA is definitely will come after this. If you are even advanced, you are already using Simple Finance 15.03, then also you are above this. And if you are already using SAP Simple Finance for SAP Business Suite powered by HANA, again you are above this. So just forget about all these things. Just remember, anything above ERP 6.0, any EHP can be directly converted to S/4HANA in one single step. Okay, again, I am talking from the functional point of view. When I'm saying the version should be above ECC EHP 0, I am talking from the functional point of view. Similarly, there are a lot of technical prerequisites also, but that we don't need to go in detail because that is something that basis will take care. Okay, there will be a lot of things which you might not be able to understand, like a Unicode system, Java system, only ABAP system. So there are a lot of technicalities. So from the functional point of view, we just need to remember that your system should be SAP ECC EHP 0 or above. Apart from that, whether your system is technically ready or not, that is something which basis will finalize. So basis will also check some things in your system. It will see whether the system is a Unicode system or not, whether it is ABAP only system or not. There are a lot of technical things which they perform, but we don't need to worry about that. Okay, so from the functional point of view, just remember your system for one step conversion must be above ECC 6.0, EHP 0, anything. Okay, and if it is not, let's say if it is below this EHP 0.8, so in that case also, we are not saying system conversion is not possible. We are saying it has to be done in two different steps. So for all the older releases, conversion will be performed using two-step conversion process. So in the first step, what will happen? Whatever is your current version, upgrade it to the supported version. So bring it to SAP ERP 6.0, EHP 0 to 8. And then from here, in the second step, we can convert it to SAP S/4HANA system. Okay, any question on this one? The prerequisites, which systems are supported, which systems are not supported?
No, Gaurav.
Okay. Now let's see the same thing in the this format, graphical format. See what is happening here. Maybe I think this one is good. Yeah. So if you can see here, what is happening is you have this. Let's see if I can add, make it bigger. And can I close this? No. This is okay. Okay, so see what is happening is this is my current situation. If you are talking about a system conversion project, this is our current situation because we are using SAP Business Suite, SAP ECC system, right? Now in this SAP ECC system, we are using traditional SAP GUI. Okay, we are not using Fiori here. The core functionality that we are using, the component, core component is called as SAP ERP Core. Okay, and the database can be, maybe we in SAP ECC we are already using HANA database, or it may be that we are still using the older database. That is the same thing. If you remember, I told you yesterday, even if you are not using HANA database, you don't need to carry out two separate projects. Okay, even if you are using SAP ECC 6.0, EHP 0 on Oracle, then too, in one step, your database will be converted to HANA and your application will be converted to S/4HANA. Okay, so same thing, your current system can be on any database or it can be on SAP HANA database, right? So this is your current situation and this is your target situation. You want to go to SAP S/4HANA on-premise edition, okay, where you still have the traditional GUI. We already use this, right? We still have this GUI screens. We also have SAP Fiori screens. Okay, using SAP Fiori screens, we can do the transactions. From the core system point of view, instead of SAP ERP core, we have SAP S/4HANA core system. And from the database perspective, we only have the option of SAP HANA database. So this is where we are, and this is where we need to go in case of system conversion. Now, during this process of going from here to here, SAP has provided various different tools that would be used. Okay, so what are those tools? The tools are maintenance planner, simplification database, pre-check reports, and software update managers. Just remember these four tools as of now. Okay, now before I explain you what are all these tools, let's try to understand practically what exactly we are doing. So we are using SAP ECC system, let's say on Oracle database. This is our current situation. We are using SAP ECC EHP 7 on Oracle database. Now in SAP S/4HANA, there are a lot of changes. There are a lot of tables which are removed. We already seen that, right? Asset accounting is completely different. It is not same as SAP ECC. The way in which we were creating the cost element is no more same. The way in which we create the customers, vendors are not no more same, right? So whether our current system, see, definitely if you go to the customer, if you are, let's say you are in front of the customer and customer is telling you that I want to go for S/4HANA. The first thing he will ask is my system ready? So what you will do, you will ask him, what is your version? So he will tell you, I'm using SAP ECC EHP 7 on Oracle database. So what will be your answer? You will be saying that yes, from the functionality point of view, your system is ready to be migrated to S/4HANA. Okay, now you already know that what would be the impact if customer goes for S/4HANA. Let's say you implemented S/4HANA, you converted the system of ECC to S/4HANA. And then after converting, customer is trying to use transaction XK01, XP01, and he is getting the error message. He is getting that these transactions are no more available and you have to create a BP. So do you think that would be the right time when customer should know that this functionality is not available and it has been replaced by BP after the conversion, when customer is actually using the system? Is it the right time that customer is knowing that this functionality has been changed? What do you think? Do you want me to repeat the question? See, you
Yes.
are, yes, you are selected as the conversion, system conversion consultant, okay? And you have converted the system to S/4HANA. Now customer is trying to execute transaction XT01. They are trying to create a customer, or XK01, they are trying to create a vendor. Now at that time, they are getting the error and the system is redirecting to transaction BP. Okay, which you already know. You already know in S/4HANA, this is a normal behavior. But customer was not knowing this till this time. Customer only came about this information when he has executed the transaction. So do you think that is the right time for the customer to know, or he should have been informed earlier itself?
Earlier itself, right?
Earlier itself, right? There should not be any surprises. When the customer is incurring all this cost to move to S/4HANA, he must be told very clearly what are the things which will change. Okay, so before you actually convert any system, you should tell the customer that what would be the impact on his current system, which processes they will be able to work as it is, and which processes are changed. Right? So let's say you want to give the list. These are the different processes which are changed. How will you create that list? Again, you want to, your customer is asking, I want to go for S/4HANA. Can you give me the list of the functionalities which are changed in S/4HANA? So what you will do in that case? What do you think? It's common, right? If you go to any customer as a consultant and customer is saying, yes, I want to go for S/4HANA, but can you give me one list of the functionalities which are changed in S/4HANA? What you will do, how you will create a list, which document you will refer to, what exactly you will do?
The document which you have, the link which you have provided, I think we can refer that.
What is that link called as? Anybody remember that? I asked you to download one document initially.
Yes.
It is a list of all those changes which are applicable in S/4HANA.
Yes.
Conversion data.
No, conversion is we are discussing now. Before conversion, there was another list which I provided. Simplification list,
yeah,
if you remember.
Simplification.
Yeah. So what is a simplification list? Simplification list consists of each and every change compared to ECC. Okay, so in short, you will refer to the simplification list, and from there you will be able to know that these are the functionalities which are changed. Okay, again, next question now. So you referred the simplification list, and there are 40 different things which are changed in S/4HANA Finance. So will you provide the list of all that 40 objects to the customer? From finance perspective, there are 40 functionalities which are changed. Will you provide the same document to your customer? Or not? What exactly will you do? Or you will just ask the customer to refer to the simplification list because everything is mentioned there.
And based on the business, based on the business process which customer is having, we can provide that part only, I think.
Exactly. So if there are 40 things which are changed in S/4HANA and customer is only using 5 things out of that, then 35 things which you have provided to the customer, it is irrelevant for him, right? Customer will even get confused why you are giving me the list of the functionalities which I am not using at all. See, as an overview, yes, before customer has not decided, they just want to provide you the rough list before giving the system to you. You can definitely give them list that these are the list. I don't know in your system which one you are using or not. But when you do the thorough analysis, when the customer is ready to go for S/4HANA Finance, and they want you to perform the thorough analysis in their current system and tell them what are the things which are changed. So in that case, you cannot give them the list of 40 objects or 100 objects that these are changed. You only need to give them the list of objects which are available in their current system and which customers are using, which will be impacted. Right. So for example, my customer is not using Copa at all. So do I need to give him the list of the changes related to the Copa? Definitely not. Okay, because it is not something which he is using. Maybe as a recommendation, yes, that SAP is recommending go for account-based Copa. But otherwise, you don't need to tell the customer at all regarding anything related to Copa. But let's say, for example, customer is not using Material Ledger today. Okay, and Material Ledger is mandatory in S/4HANA. So if you don't tell the customer now, customer will get angry if you do that thing in the system without his providing any information to the customer. Right? So what is your responsibility as a consultant in the system conversion is identify which standard business processes will be impacted if customer goes for S/4HANA and give the list of all those things. This is again the normal kind of business blueprint, or you can call as a standard document where you will be telling the customer that after you go for S/4HANA, in S/4HANA, these are the functionalities which you will find which are not available in ECC, and these are the functionalities which are available in ECC, but you will not be able to use them in S/4HANA. And these are the alternate functionalities. So all these things must be very clear before you start actually converting the system. So where exactly you will do this? All these activities, where are you going to do? You are going to do in the preparation phase itself. In the preparation phase, you will take the access of the customer system. You will try to see what functionalities customers are using currently, and accordingly you will suggest them, if they go for S/4HANA, what are the things which will be changed. Okay, but again, now my last question to you: if I give you the system today, if I just give you the system that this is my customer system, can you perform the analysis and give me the report? What would be the impact on the standard processes? So what do you think? How many days you need to perform that analysis? Let's say this is a very big customer. They have hundreds of company codes. So how much days you will need to identify which standard processes will be impacted? Just a guess. Okay, let's keep it simple. Only one company code. You need to identify what would be the changes in the standard processes. How much time will it take? Just tell something, just to make it interesting. So Mahesh, can you answer this, or Varun? Sandeep?
Maybe 1 week, like that.
Yeah, sorry, Varun.
One week, like that, you can understand.
Okay, 1 week. And after the 1 week, are you sure whatever report you will submit, that would be absolutely correct report? Let's say customer has given you 1 week. How much confidence you have that whatever report I'm submitting, that is, that consists of each and everything, what would be changed in S/4HANA? There is no guarantee, right? Because
yeah,
this is
no
a manual task. Yeah, because you are doing this manually, there will not be any guarantee. Okay, and let's say, because I made it simple, I told you there is only one company code, that's the reason you said, okay, 1 week. But let's say if you have hundreds of company codes, then is the customer going to wait for 6 to 8 months to just identify what would be changed? Definitely not. And that is the reason SAP has provided one tool called as Maintenance Planner. What is the role of Maintenance Planner? This Maintenance Planner tool will give you the analysis. It will automatically execute in your current system. Your basis has to execute it, this maintenance planner tool. So your basis will execute one report, and that report will immediately tell you which standard business processes which customer is using will be impacted in S/4HANA. Okay, so that task is not manual to identify which standard processes will be impacted. That will be done by the maintenance planner tool. It will check each and every business function that customer is using, each and every add-on, even the industry specific solutions if customer is using. Not only finance, see, whenever we are using this tool, this box is not only finance. This box contains each and every functionality, MM, SD, PP, everything. And you are not going to do this maintenance planner and other things one by one. This will be done at once for all the different modules. So once the list is available, then it will be segregated into finance. So finance list will come to you, SD, SD list will go to SD consultant, and that list you have to submit to the client that from finance perspective, these are the functionalities which would be impacted according to the maintenance planner tool. Right. So this is about the standard functionality. Now let's say this customer is using this system from last 10 years. And they developed a lot of Z reports, lot of Z forms, lot of tables. They created a lot of Z tables. And now you want to know how many of those codes, how many of those tables, how many of those forms will work as it is, and which are the tables which are no more available, which are the reports which will not work in S/4HANA because the table itself is not available. So that analysis also you need to provide to the customer, so that customer knows which of my reports will work and which of my reports will not work. So again, if you do this activity manually, it will take years. You cannot go to each and every code. For example, there was one report, you created C report, which was trying to get the data from Faggle FlexD. So you are not going to go in each and every report and check which tables are used, whether this table is available in S/4HANA or not. Right, so again, you cannot do that task manually. And that is the reason for custom code, SAP has provided this simplification database tool, which is also called as custom code analyzer. So using the simplification database tool or custom code analyzer, it will give you the list of all those Z reports which are going to be impacted, all the custom objects which would be impacted, so that you tell the customer now itself that if you go for S/4HANA, these are the reports which will not work. And then customer will either tell you, okay, these reports are fine, even I'm not using these reports anymore. And some of the reports, no, these are very critical reports. So if it is not working as it is, please make sure that this is adjusted according to S/4HANA. Okay, so whenever you are working on any SAP S/4HANA conversion project, there will be a lot of reports, custom codes, which you need to adjust to suit the S/4HANA requirements. Okay, so maintenance planner will tell you standard functionality which would be impacted. Simplification database or custom code analyzer will tell you the functionalities, the custom codes which would be impacted. And finally, there is third tool called as pre-check reports. So this pre-check reports was available in 1503, 1511, 1610. Starting from 1709 and in 1809, there is a new tool which is replacing this one. There is a new tool called as simplification item check. Okay, this is simplification database. Here it is called as simplification item check. Okay, but again, the functionality is same. What is the purpose? It is trying to see whether your system is now 100% ready to be migrated or not. So if there is any problem, let's say your system is not up to the on the supported version, or maybe there is some technical activity which is not completed in this system till now, due to which you cannot migrate. So this is like a green signal or red signal to go for S/4HANA or not. So this reports will tell you whether you are ready or not. If not, whatever things you need to perform, you have to perform again, you have to run this report. And when you get a green signal, then only you can go to S/4HANA. And for going to S/4HANA, again, there is the fourth tool that would be performing this upgradation. And this is a normal tool. Even in SAP, ECC, if you are using EHP4 and if you want to migrate to EHP5, your basis use this software update manager. It is also called as SUM. Okay, so SUM tool is going to upgrade your current ECC system to S/4HANA system. But before you use SUM, you have to check the maintenance planner, you have to see the simplification database, and you have to execute the pre-check reports. And if all the results are positive, then you will update using SUM. And when you are using SUM, if your database is not HANA already, then during the SUM, when you execute this SUM tool, there is an option where you need to tick that I want to convert to SAP HANA database also. So this is called as SUM with SAP HANA or SUM with DMO. DMO is database migration option. So you are telling the system that I don't want only to upgrade my application, but I also want to upgrade to HANA database. It is called as SUM with DMO. DMO is database migration option. Okay, and then there are some manual activities which I will show you directly in the system. Once you convert the system to using SUM to SAP S/4HANA, there are some activities which you'll be doing, which are nothing but these activities: data configuration, data migration, and post migration. So if you see at this picture once again, activity number one, maintenance planner, simplification database, and pre-check reports, these will come under preparation phase. So in the preparation phase, you are executing maintenance planner, custom code analyzer, and pre-check reports. This is installation because you are upgrading to the new system. This is installation phase. Okay, so this is your installation phase. And once the installation is completed, your system is already converted to SAP S/4HANA on-premise system. But once the system is converted to SAP S/4HANA on-premise, still you will not be able to use, your user will not be able to post anything till the time you don't complete this manual activities. And which are these manual activities? These manual activities are data configuration, data migration, and post-migration activities. So how are you going to perform data configuration, data migration, and post-migration? For this, SAP has provided another tool called as Migration Cockpit. Just give me a minute. Okay, so in order to perform the last three activities of the conversion, SAP has provided Migration Cockpit. So how will you execute the Migration Cockpit? Just come out, go to SPRO, IMG. So in this particular folder, conversion of accounting to SAP S/4HANA, this would be only visible once your system is converted to S/4HANA. So definitely when you are at this stage, when you are at this stage, when you are executing maintenance planner, simplification database, pre-check reports, you are still in ECC system. So you will not be able to see this option. This option will be only available once you use this software update manager and converted this system to S/4HANA system. Okay, so once this option is available, you are done with preparation and installation. Now you want to carry out these three activities: delta config, data migration, and post migration. And all these three activities are available in this folder, conversion of accounting to SAP S/4HANA. If you open this, there are three subfolders: preparation and migration of customizing, which is nothing but delta configuration, data migration, and activities after migration. So same thing. This is delta config, data migration, and activities after migration. Okay, so what are the activities that you need to do here? Now, what do you mean by delta configuration? Configuration, everybody knows. What is delta configuration? Do I need to configure everything? What do you think? My company code, my vendor account groups, customer account groups, chart of account, fiscal year variant. Do I need to configure again on this system? Once it is converted, do I need to create all those things again in the system?
I don't think so.
Sorry, Varun, your voice is too low. Hello.
I don't think so.
Okay. So you mean to say we don't need to create company?
Yeah,
code?
Don't need to create everything. Yes. Starting from scratch.
Okay. Yes, Varun. But why we don't need to create anything? This is not a new system. This is the old system or what?
Means everything will be transferred via data migration, I believe.
Yeah, data transformation is fine, but my question is this a completely new system or this is just the older system converted to S/4HANA? Older system converted to S/4HANA, right? If the older system is converted to S/4HANA, older system already have company code, already have fiscal year variant, already have posting period variant. So we don't need to create anything again because that was already available in my older system, right? And that is the reason I don't need to configure everything from scratch. I only need to configure what was not available or what is changed. Okay, the first thing is what was not available. And second thing is if there is something which was available in ECC, but it is changed in S/4HANA. Okay, so only those configurations we need to do. Other configurations will remain as it is. If there is something which is not changed at all, we don't need to create it again because it is already available in my source system, right? And same system I converted to S/4HANA. So only new things are added, but whatever things were available, they are already available in the source system, right? So I only need to perform the delta configuration. And what is that delta configuration? All those delta configurations are available in this folder. So if you open this folder, you need to perform the delta configuration for general ledger accounting. You need to perform the delta configuration for accrual engine, asset accounting, controlling, material ledger, house bank accounts, and credit management. See, it is not telling you anything related to AP and AR. Why? Because there is no change. AP and AR is available as it is, and we already configured everything. Okay, maybe business partner, yes. So they are not provided here, the business partner config and all, which you have to do separately. I'll talk about that in detail. But apart from that, you can see there is nothing mentioned about AP and AR. The reason is there is no change in AP and AR at all. And that is the reason there is no need to configure anything as a delta configuration. Okay, so what we need to do now is we need to execute each and every transaction in the sequential manner. It is very important. We have to follow the sequence. We cannot directly jump onto asset accounting if you have not configured the general ledger accounting. Okay, similarly, we cannot go to controlling till the time GL accounting is not completed. So everything has to be done in a particular sequence. So let me start once again. So I'm saying this is my conversion cockpit. If I open the conversion cockpit, it has 1, 2, and 3 phases: delta configuration, data migration, and post migration. Now, before you start this, there is some document. This is not an activity. This is just a documentation which is trying to tell you something before you start this activity. So let's read this document, what it is trying to say. So it is saying before you start migrating your data, please see the conversion guide for SAP S/4HANA. So I already told you last time how to download the conversion guide. I will also share the conversion guide PDF document with you with this video. And refer to SAP note 2332030. Okay, what is this note? So attached to this SAP note, you will find the document explaining you the conversion task you have to perform to convert your accounting component to S/4HANA. Again, if you go to this SAP note, it would be just telling you how to execute this each and every step. Okay, so if you are finding it difficult to execute these transactions, just refer to this SAP note and it will guide you completely. Okay, and then again, for asset accounting, you need to do this. For GL accounting, you need to do this. But if you are able to perform this, you don't need to worry about this document at all. So now, as I told you, we will follow the sequence. So in the sequence, the first activity is delta configuration. In the delta configuration, the first config is check customizing settings prior to migration. What do you mean by check customizing settings prior to migration? So system is again telling you that before you go ahead and execute this transactions, please see whether all the data which is migrated from your ECC system to S/4HANA system is consistent or not. If it is not consistent, you cannot go ahead. Okay, so if you just execute this, it will give you the if there are any errors. And if there are any errors, you cannot proceed. Okay, so currently what is happening is we are getting the error for company code A10 and controlling area A000. What is the problem? They have a different fiscal year variance. If you remember, I told you in ECC, it was okay if you have a different fiscal year variant assigned to company code and to controlling area. But in S/4HANA, fiscal year variant for both company code and controlling area must have to be same. So why are we getting this error? The error is because of this. System is telling us that this company code and controlling area have different fiscal year variants. I will try to solve this. Okay, but even if you are not able to solve this, we don't need to worry. This is just a understanding that how this errors will come. So let's open another transaction to try to solve this. So SPRO company code was, or maybe we can go to OBY6 directly instead of following SPRO. Company code was A10. A10 is assigned to V3. And in another screen, I will open OKKP, which is for controlling area. Okay, and for controlling area, A000. Okay, controlling area A000. Just double click and see the fiscal year variant. See, it is different. Okay, so what needs to be done in order for system to migrate? You have to make sure that the fiscal year variant of controlling area and company codes are same. Okay, this is definitely a big problem. Normally, even in ECC, this will not allow. Forget about S/4HANA. But let's try to change this now. So what we will do, let's go to the company code and make it K4. If there is no posting, it will allow us. Okay, so it is changed. Now let's go back to the log. Go back and once again execute this. I think it will show one by one error. So there will be a lot of company codes with this problem. So you can see, now it is showing company code A20. Okay, so even if you solve this, it will again go to some third company, fourth company. And till the time you don't solve all these errors, you cannot go ahead. Okay, so this is very important. You have to solve all these errors. There should not be anything red. Okay, so this is a test system. Everything is okay. But when you are actually working on the production system, see, currently we are not worried about company code A20, because even we are not sure who has created this and whether it is active or not. But when you are migrating this in your production system, all the company codes are belonging to your customer, right? So each and every company is important. Let me also tell you one more thing. Normally in the interviews, they ask this question. If I have four company codes in ECC system, if I have four company codes in ECC system and I want to go for SAP S/4HANA implementation or conversion, not implementation, I want to go for S/4HANA system conversion. Can I perform the system conversion for only two company codes? What do you think? System conversion can be performed only for two company codes?
No, not possible.
It is not possible, right? Because you are converting the entire system. Whatever number of company codes are available in that system, everything will be converted at once. There is no option of specifying which company code I want to convert. All the company codes will be converted, right? If he is asking about new implementation, yes, it is up to you how many company codes you want to copy. But if you are talking about system conversion, and system conversion is the same system. So in the same system, you cannot say I want to go ahead with two company codes as S/4HANA and I want to keep two company codes on ECC. Not possible, because your complete system will be converted to S/4HANA system. Right?
One question, Gaurav. For example, if I have four company codes and two company codes are already closed in 2016, say, so in that case, is it possible to not move them and move the new company codes only?
No, but Ujay, the question is, how will you do that? You are converting the complete system. You are not converting the company code. So whatever company codes are available, irrespective whether they are activated or not activated, they will all be available in the new system. You are not worried about the company code. You are converting or upgrading your current system. So again, let's take a simple example. Forget about SAP. So in your mobile device, you have two songs. Now you are using Windows 8, and in Windows 8, you have two songs in your mobile. Same mobile, you are upgrading to Windows 10. Can you say, okay, I want to keep one song in Windows 8 and another song in Windows 10? Your
no.
complete mobile is getting converted to Windows 10, right? Understood this concept?
Yes. Yes.
So irrespective of whether you are using it or not, your complete system is getting converted to S/4HANA. Okay, so in this case, because these are test companies, we don't know who has created, it is completely fine to ignore all these messages. But when you are actually working on the production system, whatever error is coming, because all company codes are your client's company codes, so all of them must be consistent in order to go ahead. Okay, so you have to keep on solving this error if there are any errors coming. Okay, now let me also tell you one more thing here.
Gaurav, Varun.
Yes, Varun.
So this customizing activity, right? So we will be doing directly in production system first?
No, I was doing the same thing, Varun. So I was coming to the same point. So
okay.
Now, if whenever you will be migrating your current ECC system to S/4HANA system, okay, and you started migrating the system, you told the customer that this is not a big activity we will do in 1 week, in the weekend, maybe Saturday and Sunday, we will convert complete system to S/4HANA system. Okay, and when you started, you found there are a lot of errors which are coming, and even after 5 days, you are not able to complete the project. Now, definitely customer will be angry because his business is getting suffered. So all these things, this should not be a surprise. Okay, and that is the reason what SAP recommends is, not even in your development and quality. Currently, if you are using development, quality and production system, create a fourth system as a sandbox system by copying your production data. So create a copy of your production system and perform one conversion and see what are the different errors you are facing, so that you already know these are the errors that will come when we'll migrate the actual system. And accordingly, you will tell the customer that we have performed the test conversion. In the test conversion, it took us 4 to 5 days. We are expecting same days will be taken in the actual conversion, because whatever we have done, it was on the production copy itself. Right? So at least one, or it is good to have two test conversions before you actually convert the production system. Now again, second question. Even if I performed two test conversions and I came to know what is supported, what is not supported, and how it is going, Will I directly go into the production system and convert? Definitely not. First, you have to convert your development system. Okay, because whatever configurations you will be doing here, delta configuration, this delta configuration you cannot do in the production, right? Production, you normally don't do any configuration. You don't open your SPRO screen in the production system. So whatever activities you are doing, this delta configuration, you have to do in the development system first. You have to create the transports. And in the production system, you don't need to carry out these activities once again. You just release the transport. So all the delta configurations that you are doing in the development system will be copied automatically to the production, which is a normal case, right? I hope you got the answer, Varun.
Yeah, got it.
Yeah, is it clear? So at least one test conversion and development system will be converted first. In the development system, you will do all the configurations with transport request, and those transport requests will be passed on to the quality and production system during the actual production conversion. Okay, so this is to check whether the system is consistent or not. Let's go to the next one. This is a technical activity. You don't need to worry about this. Set number of jobs for activities in mass data framework. What does this mean? This means that we are using SAP HANA system. Okay, and in SAP HANA, if you remember, there is something called as parallel processing. You can specify how many jobs can be done at one single time. Instead of sequential manner, you can have parallel activities which can be carried out. So how many activities you want to carry out in sequence or in a parallel manner, this consultant will define here. So just forget about this activity. Now then, there is a separate folder for general ledger accounting. Accrual engine is a completely different module in SAP. This is not about the normal GL accrual. There is accrual engine separate subcomponent. Okay, so if you are using, then only you need to touch this. If you are not using, normally many companies don't use this. They use the normal accrual functionality of general ledger. Okay, so this is not relevant to the normal functionality. This is only relevant if you are using the accrual engine. Okay, so let's go to the general ledger first. What are the delta configurations that we need to do in the general ledger accounting? So the first thing is check and adopt the fiscal year variant. So as we discussed that if your fiscal year variants are different for your company code and controlling area, system will not allow you to proceed. So this is a place where you can check whether all my company codes under a particular controlling area have the same fiscal year variant assigned or not. So for example, if I provide my company code SF01 here, and I want to check whether it is consistent or not. So if I just click on execute, you will see there is no change required for fiscal year variance. But if I do this for controlling area 8000, where we know there is a problem. So if I execute this, see, it is saying that there is a problem. Controlling area is using K4 and company code is using V3. So definitely there is a problem. System will not allow you to proceed. If you are getting this error, don't go to this step at all. First solve the error, then only go to this step. If you avoid any of the error, you will face many more errors after that. So even if it is taking days to solve this error, first solve this error and then only go to the next step. You have to follow the sequence. Okay. Second is define currency settings for migration. So these are the normal settings. These are the standard settings. Normally we don't change this. And even this configuration was not available in 17.09, 16.10 and all. This is introduced in 18.09 itself. So as of now, we are keeping it as it is. We are not changing anything here. So normally every company follows the default exchange rate type as M, and you have, this is a common setting. So according to FI currency, even in CO, we pick the values from the FI currency. And what would be used for the valuations? We always use the document currency, which is also called as a transaction currency. So in short, don't get confused with this. Just ignore this configuration. Just go and see if the standard configuration is properly maintained or not, and just come out. Let's go to the next one. Migrate general ledger customizing. So as I told you, general ledger configuration is already available in your older system. And since you have upgraded your system, all that configurations are available in the same system. Only thing is, there may be different tables. So for example, in ECC, there was a different table for ledgers. There was a total table, right? Faggle Flex T. But now in S4HANA, the ledger definition is completely different, where you need to specify whether the ledger is a standard ledger or extension ledger or which is a base ledger. So all those things are new. Although ledgers are already created, I don't want to create ledgers again, but the tables need to be changed from old tables to new tables. So even that task you don't need to do manually. If you execute this migrate general ledger customizing, it will automatically move the data from the old tables to the new tables related to the configuration. Okay, so migrate general ledger customizing will migrate all the data related to general ledger accounting settings from your ECC system to S4HANA system. Once the data is migrated, then if you want to make any adjustments, you can go to ledger and currency types, right? Which is a normal transaction which we were using to create the ledgers. So for example, in your ECC system, you were using ledger 0L and you were using ledger IFRS. So when you migrate, automatically these two ledgers will become available. Now, if you want to introduce the third ledger, normally it is not recommended to introduce the third ledger at the time of system conversion. But if you want to make some small changes, for example, you want to change something here in the ledger settings. For example, if I go to a particular company code and you just want to make some small change here, that can be done. Okay, for example, you want to change the fiscal year variant or the posting period variant. That can be changed, but again, it is not recommended to change anything during the system conversion, because system conversion, the first thing that you should do is just convert the system without adding anything new or without modifying anything which was already available. And then once the system is converted, if you want to make some small modifications, you can do that. Okay, so this is actually the activity why SAP has provided this in this particular folder, just to check whether your ledgers are properly migrated or not, not to change, just to check whether everything has been migrated correctly or not. But again, in ECC, you may not have assigned this ledger to the accounting principal. So that you can definitely do here. You can assign your ledgers to accounting principals. Okay, so you can use this activity to verify and assign the ledgers to accounting principal. Then there is a next activity to review that whether you have assigned the ledgers to the accounting principals correctly or not. So if you click on this, it will give the list of all those ledgers, particular company code wise, which accounting principals are they following. So which means ledger 0L for company code 0001 is actually created for IFRS reporting. Ledger 0L for company code 0001 is specifying GAAP. Now, can you tell me, is it possible? Same ledger is providing IFRS information and GAAP information also. How is it possible? This is only possible if you are using account-based approach. You are not having the ledger-based approach, right? If you are using same ledgers for two accounting principles, this means you are following account-based approach. Any questions till now? Is it too much? Or do you think I'm going fast? Please tell me it should not happen that I am talking and it is very difficult to understand or digest. Is it, Mahesh? Is it okay? Speed and all?
Okay, Gaurav, no issue.
Yeah. Okay, so the next one is now 3-4 you already know. The next 3-4, because we have already done this. If you remember, we assigned the ledger to CO version. So earlier, again, I think this is something which I repeated multiple times, that in ECC, only ledger 0L was allowed to send the values to CO. But in S4HANA, you can specify which ledgers can send the values to CO. So at least your ledger 0L should be assigned here to 0 version. Okay, for your company code. If you don't do this, you will not be able to post any document because system will not know that whatever I'm posting to the ledger, how it will go to the CO. Right? So at least one entry per company code is required. One controlling area is required to tell the system this controlling area will take the values from which ledger. Next is define document types for posting and controlling. This is nothing but a document type creation screen. So as I told you, there is a new document type which is provided by SAP, which is called as document type CO. Just remember, in document type CO, asset, customer, vendor, material postings are not allowed because this would be used for the secondary postings, which is only relevant to CO. And secondary postings, CO related postings are not allowed to post anything in subledger accounts. So they can only post into the normal GL accounts or secondary cost accounts. This is important. The question comes in the certification exam and even in the interviews. They ask you, which is a new document type? Is there a new document type for controlling postings? If you say yes, they will ask you, can I post materials, assets, customer, vendor posting using document type CO? The answer is no. Okay, the standard document type CO doesn't allow any postings to the subledger accounts because CO is used for the controlling related postings, secondary cost postings. And secondary cost postings can be done only to secondary cost GL accounts or primary GL accounts without any subledger postings. Okay, so this is where you create the document types and this is where you assign the document types, which means whenever you do any CO postings, system will automatically determine the document type based on document type mapping variant. So SAP has provided document type mapping variant number one. Okay, if you want to change something, create the copy like this and then assign to your company code in the next configuration. So here your company code is assigned to document type mapping variant. And in this document type mapping variant, which are the document types used? So you can see these are different types of transactions that you do in secondary cost in the controlling, and each of this transaction type is assigned to document type CO. So default system has only one document type CO. If you want to change, you can create another document type and you can assign according to your requirements. But if you are changing anything here, it is recommended that you create a copy of this instead of changing directly here. Create a copy and then after making the changes, assign that newly created document type mapping variant to your company code here. This is also we discussed earlier, define offsetting account determination type. So I told you whenever you go for FBL 3M report, line level report, if you are able to see that GL account 4000 was debited and you want to know what was the corresponding GL account which was credited, right? So that there is a field called as offsetting account. Let me show you, although I explained you, but if you don't remember, let me show you FBL 3N. And if I show for 4000 for company code SF01. Let's execute this. I want all open it, all the items. Sorry, this is 400, not 4000. Okay, so you can see if I change the layout, so change layout and bring account and offsetting account. So this is account. This is offsetting account type. This is offsetting account. So let me remove this and bring these two columns here. So, okay, only offsetting account. I want account also. This is the account. Okay, so you can see account 400 is debited. Okay, it is not minus. So when this account 400 was debited, which GL account was credited, that you can see in 200. Okay, how system has defined, how system has determined this? If you go to the posting, you can see 400 is debited and which GL account was credited. So this is for 400, 200 is offsetting account. For 200, 400 is offsetting account. Okay, so which was the corresponding GL account which was used in the posting? So in this case, it is 1:1. So whatever the amount is credited, it is debited. But let's say if our bank account is 1000 and there are two accounts, rent and insurance account, in that case, which GL account would be shown as offsetting account? That is based on the configuration that you do here. So you have four options. One is do not display the offsetting account. If you tick this, then in your FBL 3N report, if you go back to this report, this field will be completely blank if this setting is applied. Second option is display offsetting account if clearly specified. If there is only one posting, 200 to 400, same amount, then only it will show, otherwise it will not show. Third one is always display the offsetting account with the highest amount, which is the recommended one. Even SAP recommends this. Okay. And fourth one is always display the offsetting account, highest amount of all lines. So this is also recommended, but this is if you are also expecting values from MM and ST, but normally either use this or this. So let's say I use this, and that is the reason system is able to determine this offsetting account here. Okay, so this was the next configuration. Let's go back. Now these 1, 2, 3, and 4. These are the four things which are related to GL, which are pending. So I want to ask you the question. Do you